Hello everyone at Next.js Conf. Welcome to my talk, Exploring the Power of React Server Components. I'm Adhithi Ravichandran, founder and software consultant at Surya Consulting. I'm an independent consultant, author, and speaker based in Kansas City. And I primarily work with my clients on front-end technologies like React, Next.js, end-to-end testing, and so on. In this talk, we're going to explore React Server Components, which you've heard quite a lot about, and I'm here to give my perspective and an understanding of what React Server Components are. Before React 18, the primary way to render your application using React was entirely on your client. All of your code was client-side rendered, and there was no concept of server-side rendering at all. With React Server Components, what happens is it allows you to render your components on the server, thereby reducing the amount of JavaScript that is sent to your client. With Next.js 13, within the app folder, all components by default are server components. So let's go ahead and try to think about why the sudden change in paradigm and why server components. To understand this, we need to understand the timeline of events that have taken place. First, we had the client-side rendered applications with React. This was the go-to way, and there was no other way to render your React applications. In client-side rendering with React, the browser downloads a minimal HTML page and the JavaScript that's needed for the page. The JavaScript is then used to update the DOM and render the page. This is why when your application is loaded for the very first time, sometimes the user may see a blank white page. This is because the page isn't fully loaded until the JavaScript is downloaded and parsed. As your app grows, this JavaScript bundle grows, and it's going to put a lot of weight on the client side. To solve this problem, the concept of server-side rendering came into place. What happens with server-side rendering is that the HTML is generated on each request to a page. The server generates the initial HTML, and now the user doesn't have to stare at the blank white screen. Server-side rendering focuses specifically on the initial page load and sending the preloaded HTML to the client, and then that gets hydrated and downloaded before it behaves just like a typical React application. Remember that server-side rendering only occurs when you directly navigate to a page. Now, to take this to the next level, we have what's called the React Server Components. This is a complete change in the mindset of how we've been working with React applications all along all these years. You could use React Server Components in parallel to server-side rendering. They're not the same concepts, they're entirely different. React Server Components have components that run exclusively on the server. Here we're talking about component level. The code is not part of the JavaScript bundle at all, and it vastly improves the performance on each component level. You would have the choice to have each component be either a server component that lives on the server or a client component. With Next.js 13, we can now implement React Server Components within our production applications, and Next.js 13 does the heavy lifting of streaming and taking care of rendering these server components. What's cool with React Server Components is that you stay on the server and have access to the server infrastructure pretty much without any network round trips. So this is a big win in terms of performance. As we dig deep into the why server components, you'll understand that now you're going to move your data fetching as well within your server component. What's cool about this is your server component lives in the server, which means you're moving your data fetching closer to your database. Your initial page load is faster, and the client-side JavaScript bundle is significantly reduced. This gives you improved performance by keeping large dependencies on the server. Now, how does a component tree look now with the introduction of server components? Take a look at a sample application for a conference page. You could have component-level rendering with Next.js. You could choose each component on a page-by-page basis to be a server component or a client component. Here, the pinks signify server components, and the blues are the client components. On the root level, my application is going to be a server component, followed by a conference page and a settings page. I'm going to have a speakers page within the conference page and the sessions page. You can see that we can mix up the server components as well as the client components, and React would be smart enough with its rendering of the components. When you have a typical web page, you would want to split the page into small components, which you always do with React. And all the non-interactive components can be rendered as server components on the server. The interactive UI like button clicks, scrolling, navigation bars, and so on can live as client components. Now let's take a look at the sample app that I have that is going to display a conference website, a hypothetical one, and display the speakers of the conference, the sessions that they're going to present, and so on. Now within this app, as you can see, we have a conference page, and it has a speakers page as well as a sessions page. Now let's go ahead and check how the speakers page is set up. The speakers page here is essentially a server component. The speakers of this conference is pretty much static information. It's not going to change. And I'm going to fetch this data from an API call. Now this is a perfect candidate to be a server component. So by default, as we talked about, Next.js is going to have every single component be a server component unless specified otherwise. So I have a speakers component here, which is basically the speakers page. And as you notice here, it is going to be an async function because it's going to make asynchronous calls. And what's cool about a server component is you can make your fetch calls within the server component. You can see here that I'm fetching the speakers information with an API call right within the component. And then we're going to get the data back and we're going to render our speakers information as you see here on this page. It's going to render the speaker's name, their bio, and any other information that's important. Now, if you go into the fetch speakers method, I have it in a separate file here. All it does is call the Next.js 13's new fetch API, and it fetches the data for the speaker information and parses through it. So this brings us to the question of what is a client component now? When do you use a client component versus a server component? If you have hooks like useState, useReducer, and if you know that the component state would change at some point, then it's going to be a client component and it cannot be a server component. If you have interactivity within that component, things like a button click or a navigation bar and so on, that would be a client component as well. Any custom hooks, event listeners, they're all part of client components. And with server components, on the other hand, it would be something like we saw on the speakers page. If you're going to fetch data, that would be a perfect candidate for a server component. If you're going to store sensitive information, such as tokens, API keys, it's probably better now to save them on the server rather than on the client. If you want to access backend resources directly, like make a database connection, or even keep large dependencies on the server, all of that is now going to be translated into server components. To specify a component as a client component, you would have to use what's called the use client directive. In here, you can see an example client component where I've added the use client directive on the very top of the file. That would tell React and Next.js that it is a client component. You can see here that we have some use state hook being used. It is an interactive badge component, and it pretty much tells us whether a speaker is a featured speaker or not. You can see how this client component looks on our sessions page here, where we have some of the speakers, the special speakers, marked as the featured speakers. The server component calls this client component. If you go into our sessions page here, which is a server component as well, the badge client component is being called by the server component. Typically, you would have server components calling client components, and to improve your app's overall performance, you would have to move your client components to the leaves of your component tree. But that doesn't mean that you can never call server components within client components. There is a workaround to do that. You can pass server components to client components as basically props, something like this, where you would pass your server component as a child to your client components if you really have to. Typically, it's better to organize your code such that the client components are mostly at the leaf level and not at the parent level. What we're seeing now is pretty much a change in thinking how React works. What used to be client-side rendered code is now slowly moving towards server-side rendering and server components, where a huge chunk of our code can easily be ported over to the server. And that makes your app a lot more superior in terms of performance. This is a change in mindset, and it may take some time to wrap our brains around it. And the good news is that frameworks like Next.js are doing most of the heavy lifting for you. There is elaborate documentation on how to go about transitioning your application from Next.js 12 or 13 with the pages folder to the app folder, where you can tap into the features of React server components. Keep in mind that React server components and server-side rendering can happen in parallel. Your client components are still server-side rendered and not client-side rendered. You could still use server-side rendering for your client components. At the same time, also tap into the concept of server components. If you'd like to learn a little bit more about Next.js 13, I have a course on Pluralsight called Next.js 13 Fundamentals, and it covers how you can use the app router of Next.js 13. You can also reach out to me on Twitter at Adhithi Ravi, or for my services, you can contact me at adhithiravichandran.com and learn more about me. It was a pleasure talking to you all at Next.js Conf today. If you have any questions, I'll be hanging around here after the talk, and I look forward to the rest of the talks as well. And thank you, Vursal, for having me here today to present my talk on server components.